Ой, случайность-то какая.
Ну что ж. Погнали. Доброго ранку, шановні колеги. Радий вас всіх вітати сьогодні на нашому заході об майже 11 ранку. Мене звати Геннадій Білоус. Я представляю компанію Dinternal Education, і ми продовжуємо серію наших онлайн-тренінгів Dinternal Education Online. Ми з вами розпочнемо основну частину семінару вчасно, об 11 годині, можливо, 11:01. Ми зараз виходимо трішки раніше в ефір онлайн для того, щоб впустити всіх бажаючих на платформу, для того, щоб оптимізувати вхід на нашу вебінар-платформу, так як бажаючих досить велика кількість кожного разу, і системі потрібно невелика кількість часу для того, щоб адаптуватись, для того, щоб запустити всіх вчасно, для того, щоб було якнайменше проблем зі зв'язком по всій Україні, звідки ви всі до нас долучаєтесь з ваших, напевне, домівок, можливо, хтось таки робочих місць в тих умовах, які зараз склались. Бачу, багато з вас вітаються, Черкаси, Полтава, хтось вже з моєї рідної Вінниці написав, я бачив, Сквира, Апостолове, Харків, Київ, Тульчин. Надзвичайно раді вас всіх вітати. Дякуємо, що долучаєтесь до серії наших онлайн-заходів. Ужгород, Городище, Одеса, Львів тут з 5 смайликами, якщо я правильно порахував, Житомир, Запоріжжя, Тернопіль, Херсон, Коростень, Дніпро. Надзвичайно приємно, дорогі колеги, друзі, бачити вас, ну, як мінімум, у чатах. Ось, і сподіваюся, гарно з вами сьогодні попрацюємо. Впевнений, багато з вас долучаються вже не вперше до наших заходів. Сьогодні ми багато вебінаримо. У нас в день по 2 сесії, ранкова і вечірня, якщо можна її так назвати, так, після обідня. І працюємо гарно, завзято, наполегливо для того, щоб забезпечити вас цікавою, корисною інформацією під час карантину, який склався. Знову ж таки, я вже згадував, що ми працюємо з вами в рамках серії вебінарів. Вони є безкоштовними. Ми спілкуємося з вами на абсолютно різні тематики, говоримо про різні сектори, про молодшу, середню, старшу школу, про освіту у вищих навчальних закладах. І хочу ще нагадати вам про одну таку опцію, про акцію надзвичайно приємну, яку ми запустили вже більше 3 тижнів, напевне, тому по Україні. Це можливість для вас та ваших слухачів, ваших учнів доєднатися до безкоштовного онлайн-навчання від Pearson, зареєструватись на платформі My English Lab. Впевнений, дякую своєму модератору за інформацію. До речі, сьогодні модерує мене моя колега Юлія Кіянець. Юлія, дякую тобі за це. Ви можете долучитись до цієї акції, і ми вже підключили до платформи My English Lab десятки тисяч учнів по всій Україні. Впевнений, що тисячі вчителів. Можливо, хтось із вас, хто працює з нами сьогодні під час сьогоднішнього вебінару, також долучився до цієї акції. Будь ласка, переходьте на наш сайт, дізнавайтесь деталі та подавайте заявки на участь. Це стосується учнів і вчителів, які працюють у середній і старшій школі та вишах. Якщо хтось з вас потрапив сюди, хто працює у молодшій школі, для вас також є гарні новини. Ми запускаємо проєкт Young Learners. Величезна кількість ресурсів, які ви можете навіть в режимі офлайн після завантаження використовувати для того, щоб організовувати дистанційне навчання для ваших молодших школярів в умові карантину. Впевнений, це абсолютно нелегко і є, напевно, набагато важчим, ніж організувати дистанційне навчання вже з дорослими слухачами. Тому, будь ласка, користуйтесь матеріалами, доєднуйтесь. Ще один анонс. Також впевнений, що деякі з вас вже, можливо, долучались до онлайн-стрімів у соціальній мережі Facebook від нашого експерта Кріса Кьорбі. Ці онлайн-стріми досить такі коротенькі, хвилин 30-15 хвилин Кріс ділиться своїми ідеями. Він є надзвичайно професійним і діючим викладачем англійської мови, викладає абсолютно різним рівнями, спілкується з різними учнями, і 15 хвилин другої частини це питання і питання-відповіді ваші також в режимі лайв щочетверга о 13:00. Доєднуйтесь, будь ласка, до наших онлайн-включень на платформі Facebook. І ще одна важлива річ, про яку хочу згадати, це сертифікати, шановні колеги. Поставтесь, будь ласка, з розумінням. Сертифікати надходять не в день проведення вебінару, навіть буває не наступного дня, десь протягом тижня. Всі щасливчики, всі активні учасники вебінару мають отримати сертифікат. Отже, будь ласка, протягом тижня перевіряйте свої поштові скриньки. Іноді сертифікати можуть приходити у папку спам. Будь ласка, її гарно перевіряйте, тому що не одноразово вже траплялось так, що спочатку сертифікат не знаходився, але гарно покоперсавшись у папці спам на вашій електронній пошті він все-таки знаходився. Проте, якщо у вас все ж таки не дійшов якимось чином до вас сертифікат, звертайтесь до нас, будь ласка, і ми владнаємо всі негаразди з тим, відправимо вам обов'язково сертифікати. Бачу, що дуже невелика кількість людей пишуть, що в них якісь проблеми зі зв'язком. Але знову ж таки, вас наразі вже більше 500 тут на цій вебінарській платформі, і системі потрібно буквально декілька хвилин, я сподіваюся, для того, щоб по черзі вас підтягнути з звуком і з відео, і щоб все розпочалось гарно для вас також, якщо наразі є якісь певні проблеми зі звуком або відео, тому трішки терпіння, шановні колеги, і сподіваюся, ви повноцінно будете брати участь у нашому вебінарі. Okay. So I think that's it from me. It's 11:01, as I have already promised you that we are going to start at 11 sharp, maybe 1 or 2 minutes there. So again, hello, hello, everybody. We are very glad to meet you today here with on our online event here with the Internal Education. And I think we are ready to start. So right after the information about the certificates, I'd like to mention that today this webinar is primarily aimed at those of you who are teaching adult students, either at universities or private language schools and courses, no problem. But we are aiming directly at you, those of you who are teaching, well, other students. I'm sure you are going to find something for yourself here as well. Three things, and yes, and it is based all around the materials for today's session are taken from Roadmap, which is one of the new Pearson course books for adult learners. So the first thing about this book is it's published by Pearson. Well, the publisher, the British publisher, which our company, the Internal Education, exclusively represents here in Ukraine. Another thing, it's aiming at adult learners. So those of you who are teaching adults would find much useful info here today with me. And another thing I'd like to mention about Roadmap, that it's a very flexible course book, which means that if you're teaching different hours, if sometimes you need to shorten your course or sometimes you're looking for some more material, Roadmap is just an ideal resource there for you, because it's got its core units, which would cover all the basic features of this or that level. And then you've got you've got a lot of extra lessons which you could add on to the core lessons there in every single unit. And there is one more nice feature about Roadmap for 20 participants today, is that at the end we are going to have a lottery, a live one. I'm going to show everything to you, and there are going to be 20 lucky winners who are going to get their books absolutely for free. And after the session, our managers are going to contact you and discuss with you the delivery issues. Okay, right. So I think it's high time to start the webinar. So in just a second, I'm going to show you something on the slide. So that it's going to be a picture of a very famous building, very famous structure. Okay, I'm sure that all of you know it. So it's not just checking whether you know it or not. It's rather, you know, checking how good your typing skills are. So let's just, because you are going to do some typing in the chat box today, like the, well, you are now greeting everybody and writing the town or city you come from. Thank you very much for that. So now in your chat boxes, just quickly, who's the first one to write the name of this building? Okay, ready, steady. And that's, oh my, Valentina Strelets. It seems like Valentina Strelets was reading my mind rather than watching the picture on the screen. Exactly, okay, no problem. Yeah, it's Big Ben, you all know that, no problem. Thank you for all the correct answers there. Yeah, it was really fast, Julia, I agree. But, well, some of you who probably had been to London just before the quarantine started, you might remember that it looks like this at the moment, right? Якщо ми говоримо українською, як ми називаємо ось всі ті конструкції, які знаходяться навколо Біг Бена? Українською то називається риштування. Юлія, дуже вам дякую. Або такий більш русизм, який, напевно, я б вперше використав, це ліси. Але риштування то є абсолютно правильний український варіант. Дякую вам. And well, I saw that somebody, that some of you have already written in the chat box the English version for it, right? Which is scaffolding. Absolutely right. Thank you very much. Such a progressive audience I have today. Excellent. And if I ask you, ladies and gentlemen, what is the what is the aim of the scaffolding around the building, right? So yeah, Natalia Frigan is writing that it is under the reconstruction. Yeah, so the aim for this scaffolding is to support the workers, right? Is to support the builders while they are working to reconstruct, to redo, to renovate the building itself. Yeah, so it's support. Yeah, and I see many of you are writing that. Excellent. If we think about ourselves as teachers in the classroom, are we there also to provide some scaffolding for our students when they're learning English? Is this one of the aims for us as well? Sure, yes, exactly. So this is what we'd like the environment, the English learning environment to be safe for the students, for them to feel all the different support, either from us or from the material. Because if we have a look at what the dictionary says, at the definition, it says that scaffolding is the preparation for an activity provided by the teacher or materials, because otherwise the students might fail the task. Yes, that might not, they might not work to well as good as well as we would like them to do that, right? So today, oh yeah, and the question is again in your chat boxes, can you please write your ideas? Why do you think adult learners especially need a lot of support and guidance on the side of the teacher? What could be the reasons for that? So adult learners, why would they shy, Elena says? Yeah, they are not that open very often, yes, as kids at school would be. Okay, yeah, fear, Palina is writing. Maybe that's fear of making mistakes, I think. Yeah, if Palina means that. Confidence, yes, lack of confidence. Exactly, yeah, they are more afraid of making mistakes. Somebody else has mentioned less confidence. They are afraid to talk. Exactly. Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah, making mistakes and shy. Many of you are mentioning shy and fear. So let's hope they are not that much afraid of, okay, losing face. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they are adults, they wouldn't like to do that. Thank you very much. Yeah, lots of different very good ideas I agree with there in the chat boxes. Some of the things that I was thinking about when creating this seminar, one of the things they sometimes have failed too many times. Very often, you would have this adult learner in your classroom, in your, let's say, in your elementary classroom, who has come to your elementary classroom not for the first time, right? They have been elementaries a couple of times before that, and yet again they are elementaries. So they would come again and again and again because they have failed, and they need to start the same level. Right at the beginning. Lack of confidence, you mentioned, fear of making mistakes. And basically, when you're an adult, yes, you learn information in a lot slower pace than compared to the students at school, let's say. They are also very busy, yes, so they have time with you during a class, and they don't have that much time at home to do things on their own. Okay, so some of the options here. And today we are going to discuss some scaffolding strategies. So how in the classroom we could support them, what we could do to let them feel safe and to let them show their full potential. And there are actually many scaffolding strategies, a lot of them. We're not going to cover all of them today, just some of them. But just to, well, some of them you wouldn't think that, oh my, oh, that's something I have never tried. Many of them, many of the strategies we are going to mention today, I'm sure, ladies and gentlemen, you practice them on a regular basis and you use them. It's sometimes that we don't think about this or that activity as being a scaffolding activity for our students. And that's what we are going to discuss today. For instance, just to give you an example, usage of L1, right? Russian or Ukrainian. Again, in your chat boxes, can you put a quick plus or yes if you do use translation, sometimes at least in the classroom? Okay, lots of pluses, lots of yeses sometimes. Well, it's just, well, it's pleasure to know that and to see that and to hear that because obviously, yes, the students need a lot of input in English during the classroom, but very often, you could use all the options. You could mime, you could give definitions, antonyms, synonyms, pictures, whatever. And an adult student would say, okay, that's fine, but how do I translate it in Russian, or how do I translate it in Ukrainian? And they need it because they would feel safe, and that would give them the, well, direct translation into their native language of what the idea is, of what of how you translate the word. So using L1, using Ukrainian there in the classroom is obviously a time saver. If you want it. Another thing, background knowledge. Well, what I love about teaching adult students is that they come with lots of experience. On the one hand, they have learned English somewhere else, so they do have some language experience, they do have some language knowledge, right? Before they start working with you. On the other hand, they come from all the different spheres, right? They're lawyers, they're doctors, they're politicians, whatever, and they've got lots of life experience behind their backs. And sometimes in certain areas, they know a lot more than the teacher of English does, right? And using this potential, using this experience, and using this knowledge with adult learners is really, really beneficial to my classrooms. Okay, so these are just the two examples of how the scaffolding works, and I'm sure you use these two, but it's a nice way to plan this when you're thinking about the lesson and just to see, okay, here I'm going to use this and here I'm going to use that. And we are going to discuss today some others with you. So, before that, I'm going to show you a very short video extract from a very famous film, but please don't write, well, and I'm going to show you the question. Don't write anything in your chat boxes yet, okay? Because what I'd like you to do, I'd like you to watch the extract first. So it's 1 minute and something. And as soon as you hear the answer in the video, only then type it in the chat box, okay? Because some of you might not know it, and some of you, I'm sure, have watched the movie or know just the answer. So this extract comes from a very famous film starring Jack Nicholson and Morgan Freeman. And the question while watching the video is, what is a bucket list? So the gentlemen here are going to discuss that and then, well, write what the bucket list is. Okay, good. Hope you're ready to watch it. So, what is a bucket list?
What are you doing?
What is this?
Come on, give it back.
What is it?
Give it back.
Was on the floor. I didn't know it was a state secret.
My freshman philosophy professor assigned this exercise in forward thinking. He called it a bucket list. We were supposed to make a list of all the things we wanted to do in our lives before we...
Kick the bucket. Yeah. Cutesy.
Anyway, I wrote down things like make $1 million, first black president, you know, young man's wishes. I was gonna redo the list, but then...
Help a complete stranger for the good. Laugh until I cry. Not to be judgmental, but this is extremely weak.
Okay, not judgmental at all, right? So yeah, I've seen many of you writing very correct answers there. So wishes, list of resolutions, things to do before you die. Yes, okay, right. Good. So yeah, a bucket list is a list of all the experiences you want to have during your life, right? And well, the expression the two gentlemen used there, yes, to kick the bucket, which is a euphemism, right, for die. Well, somebody's writing pass away there. Yes, exactly. Well, this is quite a sensitive topic. Kick the bucket, quite, well, a hard expression there, yes, could be treated by some, but, well, let's face it, we are talking about teaching adult students, and sometimes sensitive topics arise, and we need to discuss them as well, so they know, they need to know all different vocabulary, all the different language to talk about different things. Okay, so, in your chat boxes, can you just write yes or no if you personally have a bucket list? Okay, many no's at the start, and there are some yeses, and many no's. For now, I would say that the majority of you have never thought yet about it, though many yeses again. All right, so I would go for 60 to 40 no. Answers winning. Okay, if I ask you, ladies and gentlemen, what kind of things can you put on it? Can you write in your chat boxes? But please try to be very specific. Don't write just traveling. Traveling is very broad. Traveling where? Any specific country? Any specific place? So try to visit a certain country. Yeah, so what kind of country, Natalia, if I'm... So traveling, move to Budapest. Okay, this is something very... Learn to ride a bike, France. Visit New Zealand. To buy a flat. To see Wales. Oh my. Good. Rome. Buy a car. Balloon ride. Visit India. Oh, thank you. Niagara Falls. Italy. Buy a dog. Oh my, thank you very much. So these are very... Well, audience is just perfect, ladies and gentlemen. So... Most of you are writing very specific things. And this is what I love about teaching and what I love about communicating to so many people there. Excellent. Thank you very much. Okay, good. So actually, if we come back to the book, so the idea of a bucket list comes from one of the lessons in Roadmap. So here you see the whole lesson, the whole spread, two pages there. So this would be, I would say, a typical one and a half hour lessons with your students. Yes, because, well, obviously it's impossible to cover it all in 45 minutes. So it's a standard long lesson. And you would probably agree with me that the main, part here is speaking. Lots of, why I believe so, because lots of adult learners come to our classrooms because they would like to know how to speak better. They'd like to improve their speaking skills. They'd like to communicate with other people and use it in everyday life while traveling, while working and stuff. That's why everything here is aiming at, and when my students get to the speaking part in the lesson. I'd like them to be really fluent, well, and as accurate as possible, right? But there is lots of other stuff here in the book, and you remember that scaffolding is also about material, about how material supports students to get to the speaking part. So at the beginning, there are some visual aids, and actually I saw some of you writing visuals and prompts when I showed you the scaffolding strategies circle there. So there are some visuals, and well, I would say it is a crime not to use them in the lesson. Then there goes this reading and vocabulary part, right? So it's the input of useful vocab plus putting it into context for the students. And then comes the grammar section, so that the students knew what grammar structures are better to be used when talking about life experiences, right? And all these sections are aimed at actually scaffolding, at letting the students practice all this, well, before they get to speaking and before they use this vocabulary, before they use this grammar and ideas in the speaking part. So we are going to see today how the materials together with the teacher can help students achieve better results at the end of this lesson. Yes, closer to the third part of this lesson. So today we started with you with the bucket list. Yes, I showed you the extract, and I activated as best as I could visual learners, right? Because it's always a great idea to use some video in the lesson, because I believe that the majority of learners are visual learners anyway. And then I asked you, I personalized the idea. Yes, what about you? What if you personally have, what kind of things would you personally put on your bucket list if you were thinking about that? And actually, these questions, they come from the book. So this is how the reading and vocabulary part start, together with the definition of a bucket list. And in total, that would make a good personalized start to a lesson on the bucket list ideas. After that, you remember there are some visuals, right? So there are some pictures there. And well, a very obvious thing that you could do is, you could use the pictures there. So you have the ideas here that are suggested by the book as well. For instance, take part in a marathon, perform in a play, raise money for charity, take up a new sport, go backpacking, explore the ancient ruins, experience new culture. So in your chat boxes, can you write the number for picture A? What is picture A? So what kind of experience is picture A? Five, yeah, lots of fives there. Oh, everybody's there. Yeah, exactly. Yes, go backpacking. Good. Well, if some of the students say, well, it's seven, experiencing a new, it could be also seven, experiencing a new culture. Yeah, when somebody is writing actually five and then seven, yeah, could be. So this gentleman there with the backpack could be as well experiencing a new culture when going backpacking, which is completely fine. Mm-hmm. Good. What about picture B? What's number picture B? Okay, that's lots of you, right? Six, obviously. Yeah, six, lots of six. Somebody has written four, taken up a new sport. Yeah, well, actually, it's chariot racing. Could be, but yes. Well, that's B, that's six primarily, experiencing the ancient ruins of Egypt. Well, my job here wasn't obviously to check whether you can match the picture to the idea there. Well, I'm sure you have no problems with that. But yes, you see, as we are moving on at the beginning, I'd like to draw your attention to the idea of using visual prompts. using videos, using pictures. Sometimes flashcards could work with adult students, no problem. So in this way, we as much as we can involve visual learners. And this is just part of the practice that you would have with students, right? Involving primarily visual learners and showing all the different pictures and videos there, which are very, very helpful with adult learners as well. Because sometimes, you know, about some of the activities, we might think that, oh yeah, they're good with primary students. They like pictures and stuff, but adult learners are no exception. They are no different. They enjoy pictures and flashcards. And sometimes I bring to the classroom the cutouts from magazines or just, well, full magazines with lots of pictures. And we discuss and we describe and we compare and contrast and stuff. So let's not forget about that with adult learners as well. Well, what else then? If I show you this target language again, and I would say that, well, you would agree that these noun phrases are not the only phrases, are not the only noun phrases that can be used with the target verbs, right? I'm sure you agree with me. So take part in, again, in your chat boxes. What are the noun phrases you could use with take part in? Competition, right? Let's say you play, good. Quiz, conference, take part in a race, take part in a webinar. Thank you very much. That's exactly what you're all doing at the moment. A meeting, a TV show, concert, new sport, exhibition, chariot race. Thank you. Event, exactly what I have, like a school play, a local festival. You could tell your students, yes, they really need to think of a noun phrase that goes afterwards, right? A noun working as an adjective there, school play and stuff, good. What about go? What could you go apart from backpacking? Go ahead, okay, go camping, swimming, skiing, sightseeing, fishing, cycling, running, backpacking, again, sightseeing, skating, exactly, sailing, very nice. So great thing is, yes, very often go would go together with the words with the ing ending, cycling, windsurfing, kayaking, I have here, perfect. And well, you could continue with the rest of the target verbs there. You could limit it to taking 2, 3, 4 verbs you think are the most valuable for students. But the idea here is something that I was talking a bit earlier, right? It is a good thing to always refer back to students' background knowledge. Again, this is roadmap B1 level tasks here. So I'm sure that students could have some knowledge and some background ideas of other collocations there, right? And then what the book suggests this, students do another activity here. So this is just a gap fill and they need to take the verbs in bold or the target verbs and fill them in, here in the gaps. And they, well, here is a good chance after students were thinking about some other phrases, yes, to compare what they had thought about with what they have here in the task. And then again, here, by these means, they get lots of very useful input on different activities, on different life experiences, on different things they could do during their lifetime. So, well, this is quite some practice there, right, that we have done with the students, first matching the pictures, then thinking, then referring back to their knowledge, then making some, then doing some gap fill. But you know, with me, well, like they say, practice makes perfect. And the main idea here with the vocabulary part with my students is to make sure that students really remember this vocab and they practice practice it as much as possible. For then, in the speaking part, they could remember it, no problem. For them not to think twice what noun phrase could be used with what verb. That's why, well, a couple more activities to practice it. For instance, I've got always some post-it notes in the classroom. And what I could do here, I would just write the noun phrase on them. And then I will hand them all around the classroom, right? And on the board, you just write the target verbs there. And basically, well, I'm sure many of you do it. And I think with adult learners, it's a great thing as well. So they walk all around the classroom. They pick these post-it notes from the walls, and they go to the board and they stick them to the correct places. So, well, it's a very basic activity, but I'm sure that it's very important to have it somewhere in the middle of your lesson to activate kinesthetic learners. Because, well, if we have talked about visual learners, so why not do an activity for kinesthetics, for those people who learn by doing, who learn by, well, basically standing up, approaching something, holding something in their hands, and everything. So the main thing here is to approach kinesthetics with different activities as well, because, you know, I would say that it's quite a shame when even an adult learner is sitting through all 1 hour and a half lesson without standing up and moving a bit, even just around the classroom there. And well, if we have talked about kinesthetics and visuals, yes, auditory students are left out there at the time, but, well, a very standard thing, you just stand somewhere there in the middle of the classroom and you could dictate the noun phrases, and the students would write the whole phrase, the whole collocation together with the target verb. So in this way, we would try to approach during the practice stage all the different types of learners: visual, kinesthetics, auditory. We would try to hit all the different learning types there. So we have come to another stage where we would just see the scaffolding strategies we have already discussed with you by now. So visuals and realia. A great thing, always have some magazines, some posters, flashcards, extracts of films you could play to your students. I started with the bucket list extract. Then we had some pictures in the book. Then you remember, actually, yes, I started it all almost with the Big Ben there. So it's not the last time in my session today that I'm going to use some visuals. You see that we are using a lot of them, again, for the information to be perceived in the best possible way. And well, if you bring to your classroom something like this, well, again, in your chat boxes, who's the first one? What's the phrase with the bucket there? What's the phrase with the bucket that we have already had today in this session? Okay, kick the bucket. Yes, excuse me, like Oksana was the first one. So imagine that you as a teacher just bring a real bucket, or you have, for instance, a bucket in your classroom and you just put it there on the desk and you demonstrate the phrase and you demonstrate the new language with some realia in the classroom. I'm sure that your students would remember the phrase when they associate with the real bucket there. Good. And then we have discussed with you the idea of the variety of practice. Yes, that we should better try and approach different learning styles, different types of students, because some of them are better visuals, some of them are better listeners. Like me here, for example, some of them would like to move a bit to learn things. So all the different possible ways and practice activities to let our students really remember the material. Okay, let's go on. You remember that that was actually a vocabulary and reading, or reading and vocabulary section, which means that, well, here they have the text. And, well, in a good resource like Roadmap, for instance, the text always plays three roles, right? So actually, the first idea for the text to be there is actually context for vocab that we have discussed. Yes, so in text, the students would find some examples of experiences that they have just discussed with you as a teacher, and actually this is the context for grammar that's going to follow, and we will have a look at it in just some moments. Another reason for the text to be here is actually to develop students' reading skills, right? So they could practice all the fast reading skills, all the detailed reading skills. They've got a reading task here, reading and answering the questions. So this is the second reason for the text to be there. And the third reason is actually something that I'm not sure that, well, the majority of the teachers use the text for. Actually, the third reason that the text is the model for further speaking or writing activities. What I'm driving at here is that if you imagine that you have already, the students have already got to this part, would you often refer them back to, oh, well, let's go back to the reading text and let's see how the author approached the idea of life experiences there. So we wouldn't do that quite often, right? But this is another reason for the text to be here, because the text is about life experiences. The text is about bucket lists. So the students could use it as a sample. The students could use some of the ideas, how the ideas were structured and stuff like that, to then speak about their experiences, about their personal things, or write something. So this is another reason, and I'd like, well, that this was approached more often, and the students would then also see the value for the text to be there, because it's going to be very, very helpful. So this is actually another scaffolding technique there, that the text, that the reading text is not only for the context reasons and not only for the development of students' reading skills, which are obviously completely fine, but also as the further, as the model for their further work on speaking or writing. Okay. Now, we are ready to move on. And you remember probably that the next section here on this page was grammar, right? And everything with grammar here starts with some rules. So they've got a chart with some rules and examples there. And you know what I experience sometimes with my learners, that many adult learners like to be spoon-fed the rules. Yes, they just like to the teacher to explain everything. Okay, explain the rule, give us some examples, explain when we use this or that grammar structure or this or that grammar issue, and we are done. Which is on the one hand is quite natural, because they would like to feel safe. They wouldn't like to feel stressed, and they would like to know how grammar works, basically. You obviously could do that sometimes. What the book actually here suggests, and what I would stick to in most of cases, is that I would still let the students explore and see how grammar works themselves, right? If you have a look at this chart, well, the example sentences that come together with it, they are actually taken from the reading text that they have just worked with, which lets them see the context and, lets them better see themselves how grammar works. What do we call this approach? Again, in the chat boxes, what do we call this approach to teaching grammar? Okay, Discovery, Valentina, Strelets. Again, it seems like Valentina has very good typing skills. It seems like it's not the first time she's the first one to say, yeah, well, it could be text-based. Induction or inductive? Yeah, well, it's kind of an inductive approach. But yeah, well, discovery approach. So the students play the roles of these Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watsons and whatever, and they discover it themselves. Yes, eliciting from the context Juliana is writing. Yes, so they obviously refer back to the text and work well with it. Problem solving, critical thinking. Katerina is writing. Yeah, discovery. Exactly. And actually, well, something that we have already mentioned, it's present perfect and past simple. And obviously, the text that we have just had a look at has lots of examples of this present perfect and past simple. So this is how a good resource, a good book like Roadmap works. Everything in the lesson is very, very closely linked together. Yes, the text has very clear reasons to be there, and everything is very connected and linked, and the students naturally are in the natural learning process, so to say. Okay, so the discovery approach is a very good thing to do with your students for a number of reasons. Okay. After that, after the students have been introduced or have worked through the rules, they've got some practice, right? So they've got some practice activities for present perfect and past simple. So if you have a look, for instance, at this activity, which is a very basic one, the students need to choose the correct alternatives. Yes, they read and they choose the underlined or circled, no problem. But you know, I as a teacher also have a look, well, look at it from a bit different perspective. Because you see, the task here is organized in like mini dialogues, right? A, B, A, B. And with this activity, sentence frames could be used very well. Sentence frames is something that many teachers use with their primary students, right? Primary school students. But I'm sure that with adults, it is also a great tool to use. So for this, you use your wonderful board, either green or black or white, which one you have in your classroom. Well, today, during the quarantine times, you obviously share the screen in Zoom or in Skype or whatever, so you have the opportunity to use it with your students even well these days, and you write these sentence frames there. Have you ever? Yes. Did you enjoy it? What was the best? What was the worst? Who would you recommend it to? And whatever. If I ask you, all right, where do they take the ideas from? I'm sure that all of you would write it that, well, they take it from the vocabulary and reading section. So they have worked through lots of different types of experiences and ideas there. So have you ever performed in a play? Have you ever raised money for charity, taken up a new sport, and stuff like that? So these sentence frames are very, very supportive, especially for those adult learners who find it difficult to talk for longer periods of time. And actually, this is a very good preparatory activity for further speaking, because later we would probably expect more speaking, yes, from our students for them to be able to talk in quite a freer mode. And with these sentence frames, this could be the good basis for that. Well, if the student, if the second student says no, right? Have you ever taken part in a marathon? No. Then you could also feed them in with some follow-up questions. Would you like to? How about something else then? What would you say if we, again, to make sure that they do have some speaking practice there together with their partner? Here, this is probably the stage where I would swap the partners. Yes, if until this time they have been working in the same pair, it's a great moment to ask them swap their partners and to practice asking and answering these questions with somebody different, right? And again, sentence frames, as I have already mentioned, they work fine with adult learners as well, especially if the grammar that they are practicing is quite difficult. So why not give them some support? Why not give them some sentence frames to start with and let them practice it? Okay. And after this, there is another grammar, there is another activity, there is another practice activity in this section, in the grammar section that they have in the book. It says, work in pairs, ask and answer questions about these topics, use the present perfect and past simple. And the topics are travel, sports, languages, interests, and hobbies. I would say easier said than done. Yes, so if you just tell your students, okay, so these are the four topics, use present perfect, off you go. Well, some of the learners might feel confused. They might feel that they have not much to discuss, that they don't know what they could really go into when discussing these topics. So again, why not use the board in the classroom, or why not share the screen again and do something like this? So for instance, let's take the topic travel. And I would say, okay, guys, well, when traveling, you would obviously discuss something about transport, yes, which means of transport you use. In your chat boxes, I would ask you, okay, what else can you discuss when talking about travel? What else? In your chat boxes, time, places, food. Oh, food tourism, I just love that. Culture, sites. Hotels, yes, accommodation, yes, sites, weather, who with, so you people you go, destinations, cuisines, excursions, tickets, museums, exactly, industrial tourism, good, customs, politics, okay, all right, thank you very much. So, yeah, thank you. So, I have just elicited some of the things that I have come up with before our session, yeah, types of holidays, seasons, weather, people, service, and lots of ideas that actually have come from you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. It seems like I haven't done a thing, and lots of excellent ideas there in the chat boxes. So this is one of the samples of a mind map. Yes, and using mind maps and eliciting from students is something that I find really, really valuable. Actually, I do this not only when before the speaking practice, I also do that before my students write something in class. So again, to give them more support, to give them more ideas which they can describe in written form, I would also collect their ideas on the board for them to be able to refer to it back again. Before they speak and before they write. For sports, you could have something very, very similar types of sports competitions. Have you had any injuries in your life? Have you won any prizes? Have you taken part in any of the competitions and stuff like that? Equipment, somebody is writing, exactly. So you collect all the ideas, you elicit all the ideas from the students in your classroom. And in this way, now, if If now I tell my students, all right, guys, now do please talk about travel and use present perfect, I'm sure that my students and your students would have a lot more ideas to be discussed there. So we have come to you to some more scaffolding strategies that have been discussed together with you today. So one is guided discovery. Yes, it is a great idea to let our students critically think about rules and about why this or that grammar or why this or that notion or this or that issue is used. Yes, and let them discover things themselves. What I always say is that the things that your students come to themselves, right, that they discover themselves, would definitely stay longer in their memories rather than something that you spoon feed to them. Another thing is sentence frames, right? And well, the thing that not only primary students could benefit from having this kind of support during a lesson, but it works with adult students as well. And eliciting ideas from students, or if you have a weaker group, if they're not that enthusiastic like yourself here in showering you with all the different ideas, you could always feed in ideas. So it looks like, okay, yeah, well, when traveling, could you think about accommodation? Yes, and you put it on the board. Yes, could you think about like currency exchange? Yes, why not? Have you ever exchanged currency and stuff like that? So both eliciting and feeding in ideas at this stage, here are also one of the scaffolding strategies that you use to make sure your students have better results and they are better able to speak and discuss it in the lesson. Okay. So today we have discussed with you quite a number of different scaffolding strategies to support and help your students. They were both on the side of the book and on the side of the teacher. And you see that some of the arrows here are left empty, which means just something that I started this session with, that we are going to discuss just some of them. There are a lot more. And if you research it, I'm sure you would find more scaffolding strategies there. And if we go back to the lesson, right, with the speaking as the main part, as the part where all the lesson is heading to, then all these ideas, either provided by the material, by the book itself, or provided by you, a very creative person there in the classroom, would ensure that the road to success, the road to our students' good results, is going to be scaffolded on the way. Right. So today we have had a look with you at what roadmap is. And this is actually the 8-level course. And here at the top, you could see the plus levels, A2+, B1+, and B2+. And you know, for me, for instance, very often the student the students that have reached level B1, they would hit the plateau, right? They would find it really, really difficult to get to the next level, to get to level B2, or to get to level C1, for instance. And that's where these plus levels could be of great benefit in your classroom. So B1+, B2+ are great levels to be used between other several levels there. So make sure you have a look through plus levels as well and you use them in your practice. And we have come to another great part of our session is the lottery. And just in 5 minutes' time, we are going to have 20 lucky winners, 20 lucky participants who in some time are going to get 20 books for free. So I'm going to do that right now with you. So make sure you have a good look at the screen and you would find your email address among the rest. So I'm sharing the screen here with you, okay? And here I have got the file with all the participants of today's session here. Have a look how many people have attended the session today. Oh my God. Thank you very much for that. So what I'm doing now here, I'm copying the whole column with all your email addresses. Okay, so you see it here. Okay, I'm copying it and I am pasting it in the site that we are using for these reasons. This is random.org. Okay, and here they have the place where you enter the whole list. So here you see we're at the bottom of this list, and if I scroll up again, all the participants are here. So there you go. Now, after having pasted it, I press the randomize button here. You could see it. So I press it. Okay. Here we go. We have now 20 lucky winners who have won roadmap books. All right. Here they are. Have a look at them for 1 second. Now, in just a moment, I'm going to copy paste it into the chat box so you could see them there and you could find yourself among the winners. So now I'm copying it. And here I'm pasting it into the chat box. I'm going to do that a couple of times, but anyway, you could scroll up your chat box to see this list again and to find yourself among the winners. If you haven't won today, I'm sure that we are all winners. We are all participating in a nice event here, sharing our ideas, communicating through the chat box, and just enjoying our times, right? Отже, ще раз хочу привітати тих 20 учасників, які сьогодні перемогли і отримали свої підручники. Бачу, багато пишуть not me again, not this time. Але ще раз, я сподіваюся, що ви отримаєте таке саме задоволення від нашої зустрічі, як я. Ось, тому що, направду, бачити вас, ділитись ідеями, бачити ваші прекрасні ідеї і те, наскільки активно ви берете участь у вебінарі, це дійсно насолода. І взагалі розуміти, що така величезна кількість вчителів, яка не залишається байдужими до свого особистого розвитку, до тих ідей, якими ви надалі можете поділитись зі своїми учнями, це дійсно тішить. І мені здається, що тут вчителі англійської мови в такому виграші, да, напевно, навіть порівняно з вчителями інших предметів, коли ми маємо можливість зустрічатися з вами і ділитись приємностями. Бачу, йдуть вітання з прийдешніми святами, з Пасхою. Також доєднуюся до цих привітань. Гарної вам Пасхи, смачної. Будьте здорові. Звісно, я ще залишаюсь тут кілька хвилин буквально. Якщо у вас є якісь запитання, спробую на них відповісти. І так само Юлія Кінець. Дякую тобі за модерування, Юля. Вона також знаходиться тут якісь ще хвилини і зможе, можливо, відповісти на якесь запитання, яке я не побачу. А відтак, всім гарного дня, гарних вихідних, з прийдешніми святами вас, і скоро побачимось. Дякую вам всім також за участь. Надзвичайно приємно з вами було поспілкуватись. Друзі, а що ви робите, якщо не приходять сертифікати? Юлю, можу тебе попросити написати контакти, куди можна звернутись, пошти чи номери телефону, куди можуть звернутись наші партисипанти, щоб отримати сертифікат. Дякую тобі дуже. Да, ось ви бачите номери телефонів, за якими ви можете звернутись. Мені за 2 тижні не прийшов жодний. Наталія, по-перше, дуже вдячні вам, що ви з нами протягом 2 тижнів, я так розумію, це не перший наш вебінар. Зверніться, будь ласка, за одним з контактів, які ви бачите на екрані, і ми надішлемо вам сертифікат. Так, Тетяна пише, в понеділок виграла підручник, досі ще ніхто не телефонував. Ну, Тетяна, з понеділка ще пройшов певний час, але я впевнений, що з вами зв'яжуться і сконтактують. Тетяна, ви не могли б, будь ласка, на всяк випадок залишити свій контактний номер телефону тут у чаті, і Юля, попрошу тебе дуже зафіксувати на всяк випадок, і щоб ми з пані Тетяною зв'язались. Хтось перепитував стосовно roadmap і лебу, так, roadmap, разом з вашим слухачі можуть працювати з лебом, він є на roadmap, тому всі, скажімо так, технічні можливості для організації дистанційного навчання у roadmap також є. Хтось перепитував, коли буде наступний вебінар, якщо я правильно побачив, ви на нашому сайті elt.com. Так, я зараз повернусь. Можливо, у мене там є. Так, про сертифікати. Так, сертифікати, ще раз вам нагадую, протягом тижня десь очікуйте, але якщо у вас є якісь проблеми, звертайтесь до нас за вказаними телефонами. Юль, запишись, будь ласка, Тетяна Телепей. І ось номер. Зафіксуй собі десь, будь ласка, стосовно підручника, щоб з пані Тетяною зв'язались. Угу. І ось ви контакти. В принципі, дивіться, за тими контактами, якими Юля з вами шерить, ось тут за номерами телефонів, по яким ви можете звернутися стосовно сертифікатів, також ви можете згадати просто, що ви були на вебінарі, виграли підручник, але ще не зв'язались, тому що прошу вас, колеги, поставити з розумінням, у нас дійсно зараз багато різних заходів і дзвінків, і тому просто, напевно, ще не дійшла ваша черга, але впевнений, що ви є у списку тих, з ким потрібно зв'язатись стосовно підручника в тому числі. Ось стосовно вебінарів, ось зверху ви бачите наш сайт elt.internal.com.ua, там ви можете знайти інформацію стосовно тих вебінарів, які мають найближчим часом відбутись, там же ви зможете дізнатися якусь інформацію і про книжки, і зареєструватись на наші заходи в тому числі, а також слідкуйте, будь ласка, за нашою сторінкою у Facebook, там також з'являється вся інформація. Як зареєструватись на марафон? Так, на марафон, то, напевне, вебінарський все ж таки, а не спортивний. Пані Ірино, ви реєструєтесь на кожен окремий вебінар окремо. Немає такої опції, щоб ви зареєструвались на, скажімо так, на весь марафон вебінарів. Якщо ви маєте на увазі, у нас є такий по Ян Ленес, ось буде наступного тижня, так, для середньої школи GoGetter в нас буде 5 цілих вебінарів, але ви все одно реєструєтесь на кожний окремо. Так, І вам, Яно, також дуже дякуємо. Нам приємно це чути, що все корисно. Так, ну я думаю, на тому все. Ще раз всім вам вдячні за увагу, за участь. Ще раз вітання тим, хто виграв. Вітання з прийдешніми святами. І Юля, ще раз тобі дякую за допомогу. Всім побачимось. Па-па.